With Office 365, you can set up a form, like a questionnaire or a quiz, and you can get the results of the form in Excel, or you can check it directly online. But what if you want to be notified when someone selects a specific answer? And maybe you want to notify someone else, maybe another department or another project manager, when a specific answer is selected. And when you think about it, there can be so many use cases for this. You can set up a form for your customers. And if they're unhappy about something, the right person gets notified. You can set up a form for your students. And if some of them answer a certain way, you get notified. Now, the best part is, this is actually much easier to set up than you might think. First thing I'm going to do is log into my office.com account. So just open a browser, type in office.com, log in. Then before I do the Power Automate, I need a form. I haven't prepared a form. I'm going to do it really quickly because I want to show you how easy this entire process is. So let's bring up forms. If you don't see it on this list here, you can click on this icon and you might see it here. If you still don't see it, go to all apps and then you're going to see forms. Then click on new form. So I'm going to call this anything you need. And let's add our first question. So the first one is to grab the person's name. So I'm just going to type in your name. Next one is a choice. I want to check if they need a meeting with me. So I'm going to type in, do you want to have a meeting? The answer is either yes or no. And then let's find out what that meeting is about. So I'm going to add text here. I'll go with your topic. Now I want this to be a requirement. Okay, so that's it. Our form is already set up. Now what I want to do is set up my Power Automate. So anytime someone clicks on a yes, I'm going to get an email notification with their name and their topic. If they select no, I don't really care. I'm going to look at those at the end of the week. Okay, so the next step is to set up our flow in Power Automate. So let's go back here and bring up Power Automate. Again, if you don't see it here, just click on this icon and you're going to see it. Mine is right here. I'm just going to click on that. Now I want to create a new flow. So click on create. This flow is going to be an automated cloud flow because it's triggered by an event. So let's add a name to our flow. Now we need to select the trigger for that flow. And check this out, it's right here. When a new response is submitted. So anytime a response is submitted, this flow needs to be triggered to check if there is a yes or a no. If you can't see it here, you can also search for a trigger. Just type in forms and it should pop up. So I'm going to select that and click on create. First thing I need is the form ID. We have a drop down here, so let's select that. And I can see my form here, anything you need. Now let's add a new step. Now before we check whether someone has answered yes or no, we have to grab the outcome of the form. That's basically the value this form returns. Once we have that, then we can do our check. So here's the great thing. If you just type in forms, we're going to see Microsoft Forms here, and then you have to select an action. We anyhow just have one action here. Get the response details. That's what we need. Then we just have to select our form ID, which is the name of our form. And then under response ID, when you click on there, there is only one option here under dynamic content. That's what you need. This is going to collect the responses of your form. Now we can add the condition. So let's go to the next step. This time I want a control, and that control includes a condition. So for choose a value, what choices do we have? Well, because we're already getting the response details, our dynamic content is what we have in our form. Remember, I put in your name. Do you want to have a meeting? That's there. We even get some more information here. Now, the one I want to check is this question. Do you want to have a meeting? So I'm going to select that. If this is equal to, and you have a lot of different options here, but for me, I need is equal to, and the answer is yes. And here you have to be careful. This is case sensitive. So you have to input it the way it looks on the form. Next, what do we want to happen if the answer is yes? Well, I want to get an email notification. So if I just type in notification, I have two choices here, send me a mobile notification or an email notification. This is a very simple and easy version to get quick emails. You just have two choices, subject and the body. If you want more things, more functionality, you can use send an email. In this case, this is enough. So for subject, I'm going to put meeting request from, and now check this out, I'm going to use dynamic content. I'm going to select your name. Well, this is the name of the person who filled up the form. Next, for the body, let's put meeting topic is and your topic. Okay, so that's it. If this condition isn't met, I don't want to be notified. I'm done here. I'm going to press save. So now we're ready to test our flow. I can actually test it directly from here. I'm just going to click on test. And I have the option to manually run this. So if I submit a new response to the form, I'm going to trigger it. So I'm going to click on manually and test. Now it's waiting for me to go and put in a response. So let's go to my form here. I'm going to go to preview mode, put in a name. So I'll go with Kim West. Do you want to have a meeting? Yes. Your topic. Let's go with, I'd like to have more plants in the office. Now I'm going to submit this. Now let's take a look at our flow. It says your flow ran successfully. So let's go to email. And I have an email here. Meeting request from Kim. Meeting topic is I'd like more plants in the office. If someone selects no, I'm not going to be notified. That's the beauty of Power Automate and how you can use it with forms and emails so you don't miss important feedback. So I hope you found this useful. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. Do subscribe if you aren't subscribed to this channel. And I'm going to see you in the next video.